definitely a worthy challenge.
Be careful. Predictable.
We got this.
I guess we're doing this.
Okay, here we go.
I won't hold back. Just kidding. Let's go.
Come on, bring it.
We'll banish this guy.
Predictable. Now don't move.
Do you hear something? Gosh, who knew the winds of Babel could be so toasty?
Mon! Shriek now!
Holy mom bombs!
Get ready!
Don't eat me! I taste awful!
Yeah, we all taste bad, but especially Lon.
He'll make you the one to barf!
You don't have to be mean about it. This is it!
This'll do.
Perfect!
Yay for miracles.
Now is our chance to run the past them.
Yeah, good.
It's behind the me, isn't it?
Final heaven!
Whoa, it finally worked. Oh, I can celebrate later. Come on, this way! Hurry!
The two of them have started something. Mediums have been awakening one after the next.
Then you mean the Azure Prophecy is coming true. So what? No matter how many champions arise, the laws of this world are beyond their power to change.
The only force that can change those laws is the almighty power of a true king.
We must fulfill the Crimson Prophecy. And swiftly. Are we agreed?
Yes.
Thanks again! You really saved our biscuits the back there!
Who knew they came in sets?
I'm just glad you're all right. Huge dragons live in the scars. You're lucky you only ran into the two. Normally, people don't set foot near the place, but I heard all the ruckus and knew something must be up.
It's a good thing you did. Gotta say, though, you pack quite a punch.
Oh. Well, I might have gotten lucky.
Huh?
That's actually one of my master's moves. That was the first time I ever managed to pull it off.
Oh!
I live to the north of here, in a town called Nibelheim. Come on by, if you get a chance.
I guess she's a champion, too.
I'll say. She sure punches like one.
Makes you wonder what her master must be the like.
She said her town was north of here, didn't she?
Yeah. Wait. I think I can actually see it from here.
Ooh. Something about that place makes my fur the crawl. I don't know what it is, but it gives me the heebie-jeebies.
this is a charming little town. But something feels kind of, I don't know, off about it. I can't quite put my finger on what it is.
I think it might be a good idea for us to keep a low profile around here.
Why's that?
Because... Oh, just do it!
Okay. Low profile, Tama.
Okay, Roger the Wilco.
Are you guys seeing this town?
Yeah.
If you get... You can bring...
Here.
It makes Ninewood Hills look the humble.
Chapter 11. Crimson and Azure.
Hang on a sec. I don't see any chain on the place.
Well, maybe they're like Cornelia, and they haven't been annexed by the Federation.
Good point. Sorry,
huh?
Corn... what?
It can't be.
Nice. Great memory there.
Hey there, guys. It is you, right?
Hey, super punchy girl.
Hi. How are you doing, Tifa?
It's so good to see you!
Same here. Hey, I have to ask, what are two Keepers and a Mirage doing way down here in Babel?
Oh yeah, I guess we never told you, did we?
Oh good! I was starting to worry. What if I accidentally saved a couple of bad apples from the Bahamut army?
It's weird. Why does everybody keep thinking that we're Bahamutian soldiers?
I don't know. I guess they don't see many Mirage Keepers anymore, unless they're working for the bad guys.
Yeah. And not just Keepers, Giants too. These days, they all seem to be fighting for Bahamut. I guess it makes sense in a way. They say the Federation conquered their homeland long ago.
Dude.
Still, the prophecy's a hot topic around Nibelheim. Everyone in town has heard of the Giants from the Hills.
I'm not sure I like being a celebrity.
Anyway, so you're looking for the Valley of Fire?
Unfortunately, that's the only real clue that we've got.
The Valley of Fire. Everyone knows that bit, but no one's sure which valley is the right one.
What do you mean?
If you're looking for fiery valleys, this region is full of them. But that's just it. Any one of those valleys could be the one the prophecy is talking about. Oh, right! I forgot there's a summoner in town doing research on the valley. She might know. Let me introduce the Giants from the Hills.
Yeah, that's us.
Hello there. I am the summoner Rydia.
Something here is not right. Something about you.
Hey, you know, the way that Mirage follows you, you totally remind me of Yuna. I guess it's because you're both summoners.
Huh? You mean you know Lady Yuna?
Yeah, we met her. Back on the Upper Continent. She was really a lot of help to us.
We might not even be here if Yuna hadn't pointed us in the right direction.
Oh. Well then, I suppose you can't be all that bad. There now. You hear that? These two say they're friends of Lady Yuna. That means you can trust them. For the time being, at least. So let me get this straight. You're searching for the four keys recorded in the prophecy?
Yeah. We came to Babel because we heard one of the keys was hidden here, in a valley of fire.
Right. But, you know, the keys are part of the Crimson Prophecy.
Crimson Prophecy? So wait, you mean there's more than one version?
Yes. There used to be a single prophecy, the Azure Prophecy. It only spoke of four sigils and said nothing about keys. It was much more abstract.
The Azure Prophecy is heresy!
This is no business of yours!
Lies! Only the Crimson Prophecy is gospel!
Are you a summoner or not? You should pray that fate guides you to the Crystal Tower.
The Crimson Prophecy is clear. Flanked by mirages, the chosen ones shall acquire four keys.
From the Crystal Tower they shall mount the heavens, where God will grant them the gift of eternity.
So long as you know to look for the signs, the keys shall be found.
So do as the Crimson Prophecy commands of you.
Ugh! All you hear these days is that nonsense!
Yeah, no kidding. At least they're not breaking any laws or getting violent, but it's still creepy.
What do those fools know anyway? The Azure Prophecy was written by the first summoner. It's the Crimson Prophecy that came later. The whole thing is nothing but a sham.
Still, that sham seems to be the prophecy folks believe in.
Unfortunately so. That's why I came here to sort the truth out myself. Tell me then, why are you searching for the keys like the prophecy says?
You see...
So you're telling me that your mother shares the same name as Lady Luzfarna? And you're looking for the Herald's castle to find her.
I get it. If you really are the giants from the hills, all you have to do is follow the prophecy, and you might wind up there anyway.
Right. There's actually more to it. Someone told us we would find our family as long as we kept collecting mirages and pressing onward.
Well, whatever the case, it seems the only way to prove which prophecy is true is to accompany the two of you to the Valley of Fire. In a way, you'd be accompanying me and doing me a favor.
What do you mean?
Oh, never you mind. So, are we ready?
Are we ready? We don't even know which valley to go to.
I've already figured it out. The valleys of Babel are numbered, and I believe the one we are looking for is Valley 7.
All right, Placey Place, here we come.
You see, my grandson's birthday is coming up soon, and I was hoping to give him some dragon scales. Is there any chance you... You would? Oh, thank you.
Now you're forgetting entire names?
Oh, I know it's not much, but...
So, Rydia, what's the difference between a summoner like you and a Mirage Keeper?
You know, I should be asking you the same thing. In most cases, summoners can only maintain a bond with one or two Mirages at the most. To be called a Mirage Keeper, you have to be special. Keepers can exercise power over a countless number of Mirages. How is it you create a bond with so many of them?
I guess I've never really thought about it that much. Tama, can you answer that?
Huh? Good question. I never really thought about it as some kind of the bond before.
Huh? Then Tama's not your familiar?
Familiar?
Yes. Mine is this dragon here.
The first mirage a summoner connects with stays by the summoner's side to give her protection. They're sort of like guardians.
Oh, I'm under no the obligation to protect Lawn and Rain. It's the optional.
Gee, thanks.
I guess that keeping mirages and summoning mirages must be two pretty distinct things.
As far as I can tell, there must be a big difference indeed.
Hey, you know that really big mirage we have? Why is it so huge?
It's more than the huge, it's mega! A mega mirage!
Can we even use something that big in our stacks?
Well, I wouldn't recommend stacking it on top of you. Not unless you want to get squished to flat!
Ooh, ouch. We don't want that. But we could stack on top of them, right?
You surely can, but you'll need to use both your powers in battle if you want to summon forth a mega mirage. Maybe you've already given it a try, but still... Don't be afraid to add Mega Mirages to your lineup and test them out in battle.
Sounds good. I'm the kind of guy that learns best in the heat of the moment.
In other words, you hate studying and you won't practice.
Here.
You here to match?
news! Welcome!
Thank you.